These lines lie in the visible region and they are called bomber series. And that's why they are discovered first, because they are visible. Okay, somebody had experimentally observed the wavelengths of L alpha, L beta and L gamma lines. And he gave it to Balmer. Balmer was a mathematician. And he gave a formula for calculating the wavelengths. In honor of him, this series is called Balmer series. The next set of series is called Paschen series. All these series after Balmer series lie in the infrared region. After Paschen series, we have got Brackett. After Brackett is Biffen. And the next series is called Humphrey series. Lyman series lies in the UV region. Balmer series lies in the visible region. And rest of the other series lie in the infrared region of the electromagnetic spectrum. Balmer had given a formula to calculate these wavelengths. This formula was later modified by Rydberg. And that formula is 1 by lambda equal to R, 1 by NF square minus 1 by NI square. So this is the formula for calculating the wavelengths. So NF is the final energy level, NI is the number of the initial energy level, R is Rydberg's constant. Rydberg constant has got a value of 1.097 into 10 to the power 7 per meter. This is the value of the Rydberg constant. But for problems, its advantage is, remember, the value of 1 by R. 1 by R is 0.911 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. So that is the value of inverse of Rydberg constant that is useful for solving problems. Now if 1 by lambda is R into 1 by NF square minus 1 by NI square, we can multiply both sides by H into C, so we'll get energy. So HC by lambda becomes RHC, 1 by NF square minus 1 by NI square. This is the energy in the initial orbit minus the energy in the final orbit. If you apply a little bit of brains, from this you can realize that E becomes minus RHC by N square. So what is R into H into C? R is Rydberg's constant, H is Planck's constant, and C is speed of light. So what is R into H into C? This becomes 13.6 electron volt in appropriate units. Suppose you have to calculate the wavelength and frequency of the L beta line of the Balmer series. So you have to calculate the wavelength and frequency of the L beta line of the Balmer series for hydrogen. So L beta line means jumping from four to two. This is L alpha, this is L beta. So jumping from four to two. So Ni will be 4, Nf will be 2. So 1 by lambda will become R 1 1 by nf square minus 1 by ni square. That is equal to r. Nf is 2 minus 1 by 4 square. That is r into 3 by 16. So lambda becomes 16 by 3 into 1 by r. 1 by r is 0.911 into 10 to the power minus 7. So it is easy to calculate. It becomes 16 by 3 into 0.911 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. 4.9 into 10 to the power minus 7 meter. So this is the wavelength of the L beta line of the normal series. Easy to calculate if you know 1 by r. Now frequency can easily calculate if you know the wavelength. Frequency is c upon lambda, that is 3 into 10 to the power 8 divided by 4.9 into 10 to the power minus 7. So this becomes 6 into 10 to the power 14 hertz. That is the frequency of the L beta line. Now suppose you have to calculate the largest and shortest wavelength in the Lyman series. So what is the meaning of largest wavelength? Largest wavelength means minimum frequency. Minimum frequency means minimum energy per photon. Minimum energy means jumping from immediately higher orbit. Jumping from immediately higher orbit means jumping from 2 to 1. So jumps from 2 to 1 will get maximum wavelength, minimum frequency and minimum energy. So again we can use the same formula, 1 by lambda equal to r, 1 by nf square minus 1 by ni square. So this is nf is 1 and this is 2. So we get r into 3 upon 4. So lambda becomes 4 by 3 into 1 upon r. That is 4 by 3 into 0.911 into 10 to the power minus 7. 1215 angstroms. Now for shortest wavelength. Shortest wavelength implies maximum frequency, largest frequency, or largest energy. For largest energy, the energy difference must be maximum. So jumping from infinity to 1. So Ni is infinity, Nf is 1. So 1 by lambda becomes r, 1 by 1 square minus 1 by infinity. So lambda basically becomes 1 by r, which is 0.911 into 10 to the power minus 7 meters.